Hello students, once again welcome to all of you. Myself SS Raite from KTHM College, Nasik, Department of Commerce. In previous lecture, we have completed unit number 2, Commerce Process and Payment Solution. Now today we are going to start unit number 3, E-commerce Security. In this unit, first we will see the topic E-commerce Security and Cybercrime. This is our lecture number 1. So let us start. First point, e-commerce security. E-commerce security is the protection of e-commerce assets from unauthorized access. You are protecting the valuable item that you have, such as credit card numbers or online identity, that control those value, because if an unauthorized entity obtain access to them, it could harm you financially and socially. Okay, so students, what is a e-commerce security? It means it is the guideline that ensure safe transaction through the internet. Okay, and it consists of protocol that safeguard people who engage in online selling and buying of goods and services. Okay, you need to gain your customer trust by putting in place e-commerce security basics. These basics include privacy, integrity, authentication and non-repudiation. Okay, so it is the e-commerce security. Next topic is need of e-commerce security. So students, why the need of e-commerce security? We will see one by one. E-commerce is about buying and selling product and services using the World Wide Web. E-commerce is an important revenue source to many businesses, especially with a large group of customers preferring to use their computer or tablet to complete their shopping. Okay, so you are protecting the valuable item that you have, such as credit card number or online identity, that control those value, because if an unauthorized entity obtain access to them, it could harm you financially and socially. Okay, e-commerce contain a lot of customer database, even transaction recorded. If you are hosting your e-commerce with no security at all, and others will easily steal your database, such like customer credit card. Okay, so that's why e-commerce security is need. Okay, next topic is cybercrime. Computer related crime or cybercrime is a long established phenomenon. Cybercrime may be unlawful act wherein the computer is either a tool or target or both. Okay, so students, new technology create a new criminal opportunities, but a few new types of crime. Okay, so cybercrime is specially involving the internet, represent an extension of existing criminal behavior alongside some novel illegal activities. Most cybercrime is an attack on information about individual, corporations or government. Although the attack do not take place on a physical body, they do take place on personal or corporate virtual body, which is the set of informational attribute that define people and institution on the internet. And in other words, students, in the digital age, our virtual identities are essential elements of everyday life. We are a bundle of numbers and identifiers in multiple computer database owned by government and corporation. Cybercrime highlight the central eye of network computers in our life, as well as the fragility of such a seemingly solid fact as individual identity. An important aspect of cybercrime is the non-local character. Okay. So, cybercrime leave clue as to their identity and location despite their best effort to cover their track. In order to follow such a clue across national boundaries through international crime, treat must be ratified. Okay. So, this is a actual concept of cybercrime. Next topic is resources of privacy. A privacy policy is crucial for website handling customer information or other personal data. Privacy policies are the main way of letting customer and other users know how their data will be used and kept safe. Okay, so following are the different resources of privacy. We will see one by one. First is secure. Students, everyone needs to be using a secure and privacy friendly browser for three important reasons. Number one, browser have a large attack surface and can be compromised in many ways. Number second, by default, most browser will contain lot of private information including your browsing history, username, password and autofill information such as your name, address, etc. Okay. And third one is a browser can reveal lot of identifying information about your location, system setting, hardware and much more, which can be used to identify you through browser's fingerprinting. Next is VPN. Full form is Virtual Private Network. It is one of the simplest and most effective ways to protect your privacy, secure your device and also access block content online. A VPN is a critical tool with a growing number of cybersecurity threats, particularly targeted hacking of public Wi-Fi users. Next is password manager. Many people store password in the web browser, but this is the risky because your password could be hacked by third parties since they are stored in clear text. Instead, you would be better off using a dedicated password manager. Next is private email. Many of the popular email providers such as Gmail, Yahoo are the not good choices when it comes to privacy. Email privacy is a broad topic dealing with issues of unauthorized access and inspection of electronic mail. Thus, unauthorized access can happen while an email is in transit as well as when it is stored on an email server or on a user computer. And last one is antivirus software. Antivirus software, also known as anti-malware, it is a computer program used to prevent, detect and remove malware. While not necessary a privacy tools, using good antivirus software, it is a necessary and critical steps. After all, privacy meaningless without security. Okay, the problem is that many antivirus solution your privacy and may come with some unwanted additional. So this is the resources of privacy. Our next topic is tampering. So what is a tampering? Tampering is a web-based attack in which attackers changes some parameters in the URL of website or path without the user's knowledge. Hackers perform tampering to gain illegal access to the system or valuable information. With illegal authorization, some parameters entered by the users on particular URL or web page are altered. When some information is being exchanged between client and server, that is manipulated by the hackers. Okay. So, it is the concept of tampering. Next topic is proxy server system. So students, what is a proxy server? A proxy server computer system that acts as an intermediary for request from client computer system seeking resources from other servers. A proxy server acts as a gateway between you and the internet. It is an intermediary server separating end users from the website they browse. So, a proxy server provides a gateway between users and the internet. It is a server refers to as an intermediary because it goes between end user and the web page they visit online. When a computer connects to the internet, it uses an IP address. Do you know? This is similar to your home street address, telling incoming data where to go and marking outgoing data with a return address for other devices to authenticate. A proxy server is essentially a computer on the internet that has an IP address of its own. Okay, so main concept is proxy server is a gateway between users and the internet. Okay. So students, today we have saw the what is a e-commerce security and their need and resources of e-commerce security, and also what is a tampering and proxy server system. Thank you.